Hello, data managers. This is Mr. Dunbar, and this is our first video from 2015. Happy New Year! So, we're going to take a look at sample spaces today. We're going to look at discrete and continuous sample spaces. So, let's look at three examples. So, first example, we have two players, Malcolm and Gina. They're playing Monopoly, and they're going to play it 10 times. Gina wins 7 out of those 10 times. So her probability of winning is 70%. Now, Malcolm spends a lot of time going directly to jail. And what he figures is that he spends half of his time in jail. Now, the third consideration, Gina tells him that he can get out of jail quickly by rolling doubles, and she tells him that this happens with a probability of 1 in 6 or 1 sixth. So, in the first case, Malcolm and Gina playing Monopoly 10 times and Gina winning 7 times, that is an empirical probability. This is something that was figured out by observation, in this case by experimentation. Now, the second example, Malcolm going directly to jail and he figuring that he spends half of his time in jail, that is called subjective probability. It's part of his own impression of what's going on. Gina telling him that he can get out of jail by rolling doubles, that is a theoretical probability because what she did is figured out how often you would get out if you rolled doubles. And the probability is indeed 1 in 6. So let's ask the question, what is a sample space? Well, we have two examples here of discrete sample spaces. So the first is where Gina's wins and losses are counted. So she wins 70% of the time. Now let's say you've got that sample space of 10 games and you find 7 W's for Gina. That's 7 wins. She counted the number of wins. And the second example is the rolling of the doubles to get out of jail. And again, you could create all 36 possibilities. How many ways can two dice roll the same numbers? So since these outcomes can be counted, we call them being part of a discrete sample space. Now, the second question to ask, what's a continuous sample space? So we're going to have to change examples here. Let's consider a beach ball tournament. So if we toss a beach ball over a volleyball net, we can measure the distance that the volleyball travels before it hits the ground. And we measure that using meters and a meter stick, and in this case we're going to have decimals. So in this case we are dealing with a continuous sample space because our outcomes are measured and we can have gradations between 8 meters and 9 meters. You can have 8.1, 8.56, 8.392, 56871. You get the picture. Now let's take a look at some of the examples in the content. So we've got Benson and Benson's sister. So Benson plays on a high school baseball team and his sister is doing a math project. Now Benson has an ERA, earned run average, of 3.41. What we do is we calculate the ERA by multiplying the number of runs scored by an opposing team by the number of innings in the game and then dividing it by the number of innings pitched. So Benson's ERA is 3.41. That's our first example. In this case it is calculated, but what we've done is we've counted the number of runs scored, so it ends up being a discrete sample space. Second example. We've got a fastball that has a speed that ranges between 80 and 90 miles an hour. So a fastball is how fast it's pitched. Speed in this case is a measured quantity, and that means that it's a continuous sample space. And we also can look at Benson's shoe size. He wears a size 10 shoe on the days that he doesn't pitch and a size 10 and a half on the days that he does. So the number of times that he wears a size 10 shoe, that is counted, which makes it a discrete sample space. And finally, we know that His teammates range in height from 155 centimeters to 2.30 meters. In this case, it's a measured sample, so that makes it a continuous sample space. So this, ladies and gentlemen, are the discrete and the continuous sample spaces.